Welcome you all to my next tutorial, that is while loop. So here we will learn about while loop in this tutorial, while loop with else statement also. Okay, so let's start. While loop. While loop, a while statement in a Python, executes a block of code repeatedly as long as test control condition of the loop is true. If test outcome of this condition becomes false, the loop is not entered again. The control is transferred to the state immediately following the body of the loop. Clear? So, while loop. See, they are also known as indefinite or conditional loops. They will keep iterating until certain conditions are met. The code in a while clause will be executed as long as the while statement condition is true. Fine. So iteration word that I have used here, that means wherein a set of instructions or structures are repeated in a sequence. A specified number of times or until the condition is met. So let's see the syntax here. The syntax of while loop, while, then condition, okay, body of while, find the code block that has to be executed, and next is else, that is optional body of else, fine. So here first of all we will just learn about while statement, okay, the German form of while statement. Clear? So this is the flow chart, like test condition. Okay, if this condition condition becomes false, okay, suppose that see here the while condition is a while is a reserve word, and the test expression or condition is a condition to be checked for true or false. Okay, so true or false. So here that it is consisting of body of while, single or multiple statements, or else here. Fine, or else. Else is optional over here. Fine. So in the flow chart also, what happens? Let's see. If the condition is false, then what will happen? It will simply jump to the else statement. Clear? The statement just below while. Clear? If it is true, then what will happen? The statement, the body of while loop, this one, the body of while loop, the code block that is going to be execute, it will be executed, and again the flow passes to the test condition again. Okay, so this is how it works. Fine. Next, there are some points that we have to keep in mind while using, okay, while using while statement or while loop. In Python, the body of the while loop is determined through indentations. Body starts with default indentation, and the first unindentation line marks the end of the loop. Okay, that means it is the end of the loop here. And Python interprets any non-zero value as true. None and zero are interpreted as false. At least one statement must be there in the body of the loop. So this is how we will just simply work with the while loop. Okay. So let's see here. Let's create a file. Okay. So let me try a loop, while loop. Okay, so I will simply write here that just suppose I will take the example of while loop, that I want to print the hello Python for 10 times. Okay, so I will write over here, just a minute, as for my information. So I will write hello Python, fine, then that is 10 times. Okay, fine. So now what is to be done here? Okay, what is to be done, what I have to write here. Okay, so first of all, I will write here I is equal to 1. Okay, I am just assigning the value that my loop will start from number 1. Okay, if I will write here that while I is less than equals to, let me just simply give a space here. While, okay, I is less than equals to 10. Okay, after that, see, this indentation is direct by default given by the Python shell. Okay, and after that, I will write here print what I want to be printed. Hello Python. Fine, done. Okay, now after that I will write I is equal to I plus 1. Okay, means, see, the thing is that, simply the thing is that, okay, whatever the variable I am writing here, the same thing will come here and the same thing will come here. Fine. So because I am writing, I want it, my program will print hello Python 10 times as an output. Fine. So that means, see, what will happen now? Okay. When it will be started from 1. So it will check this condition. Means 1 is less than 10. Okay. Yes. The condition is true. Okay, so it will print hello Python for 1 time. Clear? It will print hello Python for 1 time. Fine. After that, it will print 1 time. Now, after that, it will go to the next line. Okay, here what is going to be happen? 1 is 1 plus 1. So, next is 2. Okay, so it will go again. It will check the condition 2 is less than equal to 10. Yes, it is true. See, suppose this condition becomes false. So what will happen here? It will stop running the statement. Means it will not execute anything. Fine. If suppose I have a number here 15. So 15 is less than equal to 10. It will check this condition. If it is false, then it will directly jump to the end. Fine. Clear? This is simple while loop. So let's see here. Let me run or save. I will write here while. Okay, WHI while. And I will run and see the output. See, so it has printed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 times. It has printed 10 times. Okay. So here, this is what that we are going to do. So if I will run it again, okay, if I will run again, this my program, okay, now the difference. One by one, it has run the all the things, okay. Now, suppose I just want to know the numbers also. Okay, means hello world first statement, hello Python second statement, then hello this and third statement. Okay, then how to do that? Okay, we will see that also. Clear people? Let's see. So let's do the editing here, a bit editing, okay. Simple condition is same and I will write here F. And then after that, I will ask it for the numbering. Okay, that is I, because it is starting from I only, okay. So let's check, save and run. Now you will see, you will be able to see it is running from 1 to 10. Just suppose if the number is, suppose I am starting this not from 1, okay, and I am starting it from 2. So how it will work, just see, it will start from 2 to 10. Clear? So this is how my simple while loop works. Clear? So let's create a file again and do the sum of the numbers. Okay, sum of 1 to 10. Okay, so write down total is equal to 0. I am initializing the value here. Then I am writing I value. I is equal to 1 because I want to start it from 1. Okay, I want to add 1 to 10. Clear. Then after that while condition, it will check the value, that is I is less than equals to 10. Clear. And after that it will say total. Okay, total equals to total plus 1. Okay, total equals to total plus 1. Fine. After that I will write I is equal to I plus 1. Clear. Then enter. Now I have to write the print statement. What it has to print? Print is total. Okay. Clear. So let's save it and let's see the output. I will write here sum 1. Okay, save and run this program 10. So it is displaying the answer 10. Let's go back again. Just a minute. Total is equal to I should come to less 55. Okay, so it is showing me the answer 55 over here. Okay, because I have written by mistake in place of I have written 1 here. Okay, so now what is happening over here? You just look very carefully. I have given the 0 value as a total. Clear, I don't have anything. Now next is, it is saying I is equal to 1. It will check the condition. 1 is less than equal to 10. Yes, if it is true, it will check the condition. Okay. And it will check the condition. If it is true, then it will move forward, that it will do total 0 plus 1. So what value will come here? Total is equal to 0 plus 1. Okay, here. Now here the value of I, what is becoming the value of I now? I is equal to 1 plus 1. Okay, so that is 2. So now the current value of I is 2 here. Okay, now it is 2. Clear. After that, same way it will simply check 2 3 4 5. Okay, and it will simply display as the sum. If suppose I am writing here the value 20. Okay, so same procedure will run for 20 also. Save and let's see. The sum is 210. So you can apply the while statement here as a while loop in the Python. Okay, so let's move forward now. So now we will use while loop with else. See, if the else statement is used with the while loop, the else statement will be executed when the while condition becomes false. Okay, so this statement will be executed only when this while condition will become false, like here. So if it is false, so it will execute statement just below the while. Okay, so we will understand this also with the help of one simple example. Okay, so that it will be more clear. So let's create a new file here. Okay, new file, and simply let's create password. Okay, password is equal to something. Okay, and I will use while password is not equal to, password is not equal to secret. So here I will check my password. Okay, clear, done. Now after that password, I will take the password from the user also. Okay, so that we can just simply check it. Input, please, we will write please enter the password. Oh, I'm using the shortcut, but let me do and write again. Please enter the password. Fine. Let's close it. And after that, I have to apply the if statement. If password is equal to, if now I have to check if password is equal to secret, okay, then print thank you, thanks, okay, then I will say thanks, you have entered the correct password, clear. So after that, after this, okay, now after this I will go to else statement, okay, else. Otherwise what it has to do, it has to say print sorry the password is incorrect, try again. So let's save this program, okay, just save it and run it. So it is asking me enter the password. So if I am writing here something else, I am writing here Tanav. Okay, it is saying sorry, the password is incorrect, try again. If I will write here again, suppose I am writing here correct password, it is saying sorry again. Why it is saying like this? Because my YP password is secret, the password is secret only, is equal to secret. Yes, I have entered the correct password this time. So why it is not taking it? See, here if you never enter the correct password, that is secret, then the while loop's condition will never be false. And the program will just keep asking the password forever. So secret, password, secret, done. Okay, it's okay, print this and that, everything is fine here. What is missing? What is missing? Just check me. Okay, if I'm writing here secret and running it again, okay, please enter the password, it will not run. Okay, if I will go again and just simply make it empty, okay, and then save, and I will simply ask for the password. Password secret. Thanks, you have entered the correct password. So these are the things that we have to take care. Okay, so this is how we can use the while statement using the else. Okay, so here what is happening, while if password is not equal to this, okay, so that means it has to check first condition, means the password you will enter, if that is not equal to secret, then what it will go, it will move to, okay, if it is true, then it will move forward. Password is equal to secret, then it will display, means same password, secret you have typed, it will display thanks, you have entered the correct password. Otherwise, if this becomes false, okay, if the statement becomes if you never enter the correct password, I am repeating again, then the secret, that is secret, then the while loop's condition will never be false and the program will just keep asking you password forever. Okay, I hope you have understood this. Thank you. So guys, there is a thing that I would like to tell you, that difference between if and while loop. if statement and while loop. Okay, if statement checks whether an expression is true or false and then runs the code inside the statement only if it is true. The code inside the loop is only run once. Okay, but in while, a while statement is a loop. It continues to execute the code as long as the expression is true. Okay, so the thing, I hope the difference between if statement and while loop is clear to you. Okay. Thank you guys. If you liked my video, please subscribe and keep visiting my channel for new updates. Thank you.